Good evening. Thanks for being tolerant. We had a little backup on the start of our gathering this evening as employees get the joy and thrill of open enrollment for health insurance and other things. We went through that a little bit in my world today at beautiful Lawrence North. And it is cold in here, so you can put that into the minutes. Let it be known that the AC works. Nothing else may work. The AC works. So, folks, hey, real quick, we know we did not have a gathering back in October. Miss D did get to us the minutes way back in September. If you had a chance to peruse them, I would entertain a motion to accept the minutes as submitted by Miss D.
I'll move that.
Second?
Second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
All right. Mr. Martin? What do you have for us, sir?
Just a couple quick items. We had a community day at Lawrence Community Park. The students from Harrison Hill built the maze, or what, you know, the artistic piece out at Community Park. We had several adult volunteers helping them out, and they did a very good job. We were supposed to have some tree planters there, and we didn't have enough volunteers for that, so the park staff planted 35 trees, I believe it was, at Community Park throughout the various areas. So we did that on the 29th. Then we had our Fall Festival Halloween party, and if you haven't seen the city's Facebook page, you ought to go to that. We had some very cute costumes, and it was very well attended this year.
Anything else exciting?
That was it.
Wow. A couple things for me, since we didn't gather last month. We did a chance to go out to Lee Road Park in October. We had a gathering. Is it workforce?
It was workforce.
Indy Due Day?
Yeah.
Indy Due Day.
That was September 30th.
Yes, on September the 30th. And we had an Indy Due Day workforce. We had students from Lawrence Central, who left early because it rained. I can throw that in there. And Lawrence North. Hey, that's my alma mater. And Lawrence North, several service groups. And what we got started on is basically some projects with the former occupants of the baseball facility that was cleaned up, the connection between Fall Creek Valley Middle School and Lee Road Park, working on that pathway, concessions, the outbuildings being painted. It's a pretty cool day. Eric and his staff, what did we fill, two dumpsters?
Two 30-yard dumpsters of trash from the diamond, yeah.
It was quite a day. I was proud of my kids, myself, Coach DeLuna, Coach Morgan from Lawrence North. It's very cold, very cold. Now I know why I have to get a back surgery. Either I'm soft, but at high five, it really looks good. And Indy Due Day went on all throughout Lawrence Township that day. But I just want to high five my kids who were out there. No gripes. The only gripe they had is they had to eat the sack lunch from the middle school. And I said that it's good for them. Put a hair on their chest.
You might add, Jeff, that workforce came back out.
That's right.
To help Fall Creek baseball and softball and baseball finish the concession stand. They also started painting the scoring towers out there. So
it was kind of neat. It's just type of work I know with the size of our regular staff can't get done in the timely matter we'd like. So it was pretty cool. Eric, just a couple of things real quick, going through the budgets, any transfers we see coming up and the like to get through the year, end of the year?
Yeah, we're going to have to. Our utilities are way short. Dina and I have been almost daily reappropriating. We can do it in a line transfer now within our New World system. With approval from the controller, so we can do it like in the 200 series, we can transfer monies in. But we're at that point in the year where we're going to have to do something outside of probably the 200s, some money's into the 300s to cover utilities.
Oh, okay.
Into 200 for utilities. The Parks Board can do that, and we'll probably need a special meeting sometime before December to do that.
Okay. And keep that in mind. I'll just throw my last 2 cents. I was telling the folks I won't be around for a December meeting. I'll be laid up. I'll have back surgery. So if we need a special meeting, just don't hesitate to bark, and we'll get three folks, and we can work on this together and the like. Anything I might have carried over, anything budget-wise other than transfer that comes out or is glaring in our budget report or anything?
Utilities, and we're low on, of all things, our refund reimbursements out of our 339 account, or 339, which is a good thing. That means we've had a lot of rentals this year, so we didn't budget enough into our non-reverting account, so we've got to transfer money into that that account, and because it just comes right out. So,
all right, colleagues, anything for Mr. Martin and company?
Trees look good. Like the trees.
Those are from Ski Landscaping from their nursery down on Acton Road. And they also, I have to thank John Wolski too. He donated additional 12 or 14 of just big maple trees that they couldn't utilize. Also, all the trees that are going in building one and new parking lots are also from his nursery. So he did a very good, gave us a very good price. And then we also got some trees that were park grade, so they're a little crooked, but
it'll
be nice.
It's a minor issue.
Puts the, I was going to say, adds character to the place.
Yeah. Is the maze, or whatever we're calling that, is that done?
Yeah, I think they're going to come back in and do some additional fill in around the area, but as far as the materials are laid in,
now the bricks are, they're loose.
They are. They've told me that they'll come back and check them periodically. I'm sure we'll have to probably check them daily almost.
But
knock on wood, so far I haven't seen any in the community center or anywhere else.
Okay.
Anything else? Nothing new, any committee reports. Like I said, I've been worried more about my bad back than my standing committee, so we hopefully get back to that. Go down under old business. 6A needs to be omitted, please. And under new business, we have three facility usage agreements. Mr. Eric, Miss Mara, would you want to walk us through them there?
Yeah, we've gotten our first three applications to utilize the parks in 2017 back. And just to go over the process, I will let you know what they've requested. The Parks Board can vote on all those terms, and then I'll finalize the documents and bring the signatures back to the next meeting. So the first one was requested by Fall Creek Softball and Baseball. This was formerly Fall Creek Little League. They have dropped the Little League affiliation and will be playing under different rules. They, of course, would like to stay at Lee Road Park with their 6-7 fields, the garage, utility closet and restrooms, flagpoles, score boxes and boards. And they may be sharing the indoor batting cage with the township schools. That's still under discussion. They have requested November 1st of this year, carrying over into October 31st of next year, so a full year, along with a right of first refusal to the senior field from August 1st, 2017 to October 31st, 2017. The township schools have said they're okay with that. That is their off season. So Fall Creek is now looking at doing a fall season.
Okay, good.
So if they do, they would like to use that senior field. So taking the estimated number of kids that would be participating in both seasons and multiplying by $15 each, that comes to 9,000. The 2016 agreement was $10,000 of capital improvements or in kind. So board will need to discuss how you would like the $9,000 for 2017 divided. All the other terms remain the same.
All right. I guess I'll throw this out. Eric, how the 9,000 guys throw stones at me. The 9,000, do we have specific things that need to be done to either upgrade or maintain that needs, do you have projects?
Of course, you've seen the interior that.
Oh, God.
And the exterior, some of those buildings that we've taken back over that mm-hmm. could use.
Lots of work.
Yeah. And, you know, we have another path for some of those repairs. But,
right.
I would feel comfortable if the board requested some financial backing from the league to help offset. You know, we're putting in new LED lights in the parking lot this year. So I think some monetary offset would certainly help us in our budget situation.
Are there any issues with parking that possibly, I mean, that's always an issue with all of our youth activity parks. Are any issues with parking that could be addressed or needs to be addressed financially, or is it an imperative?
In that particular park location, in conjunction with the school next door, there's ample parking.
Oh, okay.
Especially with the landscaping that was done, opens up that visibility between the parking lot at Fall Creek Valley Middle School and mm-hmm. the facility. So,
do you have a cost maybe for what those LED lights might be?
We are replacing two out there, and it's roughly $1,800 a piece, I think. We're not sure. We're doing the ones at the soccer facility. And then we've also got two extra lenses or two extra fixtures that we're buying. So okay. We'll replace two out there. And I think the full cost of the project was right at $3,800 for the 10 lights that we're doing. So $380 a piece. It would be
they should last for a little bit.
You said $1,800.
Colleagues, especially in the financials and anything.
What did they spend the $10,000 for last year?
We have not seen the, I have not seen the
actual receipts.
I know they, on the Indy Due Day, they bought $400 or $500 worth of paint. I did see that.
Didn't they put a new roof on one of the buildings?
They did put a new roof on the one of the storage facilities. They built a new scoring tower on one of the diamonds, but we have not seen the list, which I think that's something that should have came along with this proposal.
Yes.
We should have had last year's total, but I know in mowing that they spent that much in mowing with their mowing contract.
Okay.
And they have agreed in principle to, when they're on the senior field, that they'll do the maintenance on the senior field also. They'll do the mowing and the diamond prep on the senior field.
And with that senior field, when the township is on the senior field, roughly, March and April, May-ish, that's going to be in the townships.
The township will take care of that.
Okay.
And then when Fall Creek baseball's on it, then they'll do it. And then time that they're not somebody on it, then we'll mow it.
Okay. All right.
They need it on November the 1st because of the batting, indoor batting, is that it?
Yeah, they're potentially going to be in there during the winter doing some practices.
That's a long way off.
That's a long way off.
That's an understatement.
It's in really bad shape.
It's like me. It's weathered pretty badly.
Taking a few hits.
Yeah, well, it's taking a lot of hits.
Okay.
So there you go. All right.
The parking lot out there, Lee Road Park, and that the one closest to the road.
The gravel lot.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Gets a little ratty.
It is.
And they do park on the grass out there, too. So I've seen parking on the grass, which is not good because that's, you know, we get soft out there.
I'm hoping with our new partners there that won't happen as often. But people are just that way. They just take the short
track. I know. We've talked about that. People park.
The only thing we could add would possibly be some bollards along there or something to
discourage parking.
Discourage,
because it gets, when they go across the grass when it's wet, it leaves ruts and doesn't look very good.
Right. We can go out and kind of grade it out and see if that helps. But other than putting in bollards or parking or car stops, it'd be hard to do.
Yeah, it's some, I don't know whether it's worth worrying about, but
yeah.
Definitely pay attention to it, yeah.
Or we'll plant some trees out there.
That's it. I'm always in favor of trees.
I am too, yeah.
In favor of a good tree. Anything else? Well, folks, if you'll craft us a motion here for Ms. Mara to go forward.
I'll move whatever Mara said. I always move what you say. I'm not sure what I'm...
Are you wanting to...
The financials, I think that we need to. Yeah, we estimated $9,000, and it's whatever is the wishes of the board, but I think we should get some actual payment from the leagues.
Especially for the lighting. I think that's your motion.
So $3,700. Are we talking about that? And that they would that would be cash to us.
That and any utilities that we might utilize out there, I think is fair to ask for monies back for and utilities. That particular facility we pay the water and the electric just on the parking lot and the concession stand. So we're probably at $150 a month or so on those utilities. So the months that they're there, I would say an extra $1,000 for utilities would probably cover it.
So we're roughly looking at $9,000. We're looking at a 50% payment in kind, or payment loop for utilities and the lighting and for their in-kind services. So about 50-50 breakdown.
I'll move a 50-50 breakdown on that.
Do I get a second?
Yeah. I'll second. There you
go. All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Let's just make sure we get their breakdown of where they spent their cash last year.
Okay.
All right, Counselor, we got the usage agreement with the football folks.
Yes, the second special use agreement proposed is with Lawrence Township Football League. This is for Burns Park, for the fields, restrooms, concession stand, July 1st of 2017 to November 15th of 2017. The $15 per child total comes to $6,195.
All right.
What was the money again?
July 1st to November 15th.
Eric, what was our breakdown from our friends this past season? Do you remember? Excuse me.
from my understanding, we did receive monies from the lacrosse and the Gaelic group, but we did not receive any financial assistance from the Lawrence Football.
Well, that's not good.
Their license application states LTFL has a very limited budget and needs all possible financial assistance. We are willing to contribute significant time and effort. Any available capital is used to improve our league and Eugene Burns Park.
All right. Now, is this another thing where we need to payment in lieu? You know, in-kind services. This is another one where we need to discuss with them specific projects needs to keep that field up and going? How do you feel?
The fields themselves, they have been working on and have done some work this year.
Mm-hmm.
But again, we're paying utilities on the concession, and we should get some financial.
Do you know what our commitment monetarily is, utility-wise?
I would say it'd been close proximity to what we're
paying
Wall Creek.
Okay. We do the mowing there.
We do, yeah. We do not line the fields. Right. They do their own lining, but we maintain the all the other facets of it, trash pickup and everything else.
Is there anything else that needs to be worked on there?
You know, the fields were in pretty good shape this year.
They look better.
Yeah, I think that was just circumstances of weather this year. The fields, and we took the monies from the Gaelic group, and that went into purchasing some of the materials for
field maintenance and
field
the like.
Maintenance.
Colleagues, it's probably another one of those where looking at a 50-50 in kind.
Well, do we need 50 from them? I mean, we said 1,000 for the lights. Is that,
these are just just ballparking utility costs. And there we do have gas, but that's just for hot water heat. And then we have, of course, electricity for air conditioning and lights.
And I guess my point is, I know we cut the fields too, correct?
Correct.
Yeah. I was throwing out that 50-50 concept.
So will we get pushback on that though from them if they're that limited? Because I think they do. I mean, they do a lot of scholarship type things.
Right.
So
I'm sure we can always ask Virgil to come in and explain. We have not seen their year-end expenditures either, so that would help, I think.
Well, if they don't need it till July, we could wait on that.
Ask them.
Somebody come in. And
is this one of those, Ms. Marr, that we... I'm just throwing this out. That's me just throwing it out. Advocate for 50-50, and then we can come back and address it.
You can make a motion to split it however you like and approve it, and they can always come and request an amendment to the license.
All right.
Does it have to be done now before the end of this year?
We've been trying to get them all scheduled for 2017, so we know what openings we have when new groups arrive.
So we've got two out of the three here that haven't given us any financials?
Yeah.
Especially if they're... I think we should see their financials before we give them a price. How can you consider them if you don't know what they're doing?
Right. From the Fall Creek Little League, we know from experience.
I just think it looks bad if we don't at least see financials from these groups.
Well, that's perfectly fine. I think that maybe the application process requires, because they do have to send in their certificate of insurance and their state filings
I appreciate what they do, and I mm-hmm. know they do yep. have a lot of scholarship or gifting of some of their fees.
Correct.
And we can, I'm agreeable to giving them credit for that, for what they do to the community, but I do think it makes it is a bad precedent if we don't at least see their financials.
I'm kind of leaning in that direction. I personally would feel better. It'd be probably something you guys act upon next month, minus me, but I would feel better. That's called Peyton Manning there, boys. I just hand it off. No fumbling there.
Give us the ball.
I mean that.
We'll run with it.
Okay, but I'd feel better that with letter B there that we table that until we get a chance to see their financials, and the sooner the better.
Okay, I would would suggest that. Okay. I would suggest that we table this until we see their financials.
Yeah.
Maybe it'll spur their activity to bring it in.
There you go. So
is there a second to that?
Second.
Yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right.
The third facility usage agreement is with Backyard Barbecue.
That just sounds good.
Yes, this is actually a new application and not a renewal. So we need a lot more details from them. They requested Friday or Saturday, but I don't know from when to when.
Yeah, it's a new, they're not in Lawrence, actually. I think he's outside of Lawrence. It's a new truck,
mm-hmm.
and he is trying to make payments on his, his vehicle.
His investment.
He is mandated by Marion County Board of Health that he can only open up when it's 40 degrees or warmer.
Right.
He was just looking at a Friday or Saturday evening or where he can get on social media and say, well, I'm going to be at Lawrence Community Park.
Oh,
I'm going to
okay.
be at Veterans Park. From this time to this time, if you want to come by and sample. And he has been asked to be in our farmer's market that starts June 1st of next year here on on the Fort property.
But because I need to verify a few things regarding zoning and his peddler's permit and how those work together, I would request that the board table this for now.
Yeah. Agreed.
I'll move that.
Second?
I'll second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
Once he's up and going, I'm all for it.
Just one comment about that. Would he be there at any time when the concession stands are open?
Yeah, good point.
Our short discussion we had just the other day was just this winter. He's just looking for, because once his, he participates at the Benford Market, which is at Lawrence North on Saturdays, correct?
Yes, first week in May to the last Saturday in October.
So that's Saturday, mm-hmm. and presumably we'd be there.
Yeah.
And again, I think this is just something to look during the winter months to, where he can locate and
okay, because I wouldn't want
and have ample parking and ample light and that sort of thing.
Okay,
so.
I see what the deal is.
Yeah, don't want to take money out of our youth.
Concession stands.
And then it's not on the agenda because we don't have it drafted yet, but I did get a verbal request for a 2017 facility usage agreement for the Lawrence Soccer Club and have been discussing those terms with one of their new board members, Ms. Alvarez.
Okay.
So that should be on your December agenda.
Got it. And I would like to take an opportunity when that, prior to December 6th, I'd like to convene all the interested parties, a little soccer committee gathering prior to December the 6th. That's after that. I'm handing off to you guys again completely.
December the 6th.
Okay, so folks would scary their calendar books. I'd like to have a soccer committee meeting prior to December the 6th, please. And all interested parties, we will chit-chat and try to arrange that.
Now, how many different soccer entities are there now?
There's the Lawrence Soccer Club, and there's FC Pride is the and travel portion, and there's several adult primarily Hispanic programs.
Okay.
There's actually three different Hispanic programs.
Yes. Pride, Jesus.
And then there's this state adult group, so there's
I guess the bigger question, how many adult leagues are we?
Right now we're dealing with three different groups.
Wow. Huh. Things to make you go, huh? Okay. Anything else? Eric, what we got fun coming up on the upcoming calendar of events in our fair land?
You know, January or November's pretty thin for us. Most of my guys are going to be on vacation, so there's not a lot going on in the Parks Department.
The tree lighting's on what date again? In the
26. Thanks, Dina, for reminding us. We're going to have the tree lighting this year at the Sterrett Center. program starts roughly at 3:30 with a parade of Lawrence departments. The Parks Department has something in store that...
Is it pretty special?
We think so.
Cousin
we
Eddie? So. I'm suddenly uncomfortable.
And
that's how we get in the newspaper, all the wrong reasons.
And then we're going to have, of course, the lighting, and Santa Claus will be here, and we'll have some entertainment. Lawrence, or the Harrison Hill students are singing some Christmas carols, and...
festive music.
We have a Festivus Bowl.
Okay. Well, we'll make it a gala out of it. God.
But it is at the Sterrett Center this year, not here at the Government Center, so.
Oh, all right, good. All right, colleagues, public comments, folks. Come on. Go ahead, huh? And they got the microphone going the wrong way, so you're okay. You're amongst friends, you know that.
I'm Patty with Lawrence Soccer Club. I wasn't sure we were told to come to the meeting tonight, so I was with the understanding that what should be heard was that, is that not the case?
Public comments, go ahead. Yes, this is the podium's yours.
Okay. We were asked to bring forth our request for what we would like to see our contract consist of. And it's kind of, we're short notice, so it's not as professionally put together as we'd like. But so,
I like bullet points.
Knowing that we have December, we'll have it together. Some of the things, and please bear with me, do not think that we're trying to be extravagant. What we did was put a list together of, let's say, needs, and then wants, what we would like to see, our dreams, aspirations. Don't know if that can be done, but you will be able to tell us.
If you notice with our youth leagues, I always throw Eric out, what do they need and what they...
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. So, shoot for the sky.
Our list consists of one thing that we would like to ask is that the field that we are on be donated to Lawrence Soccer Club. The reason why I believe that might be a possibility is because the time that I have been with Lawrence Soccer Club, that was the... I guess the thought that the fields had been donated to, I don't know, I've always said us. I've always heard us. I don't know who us is. So with that being said, that is something that we would like to request, if that is possible, that the fields be donated to Lawrence Soccer Club. And with that being said, we would still pay, because we had been paying, so we would still pay per player. So I see you all kind of looking at me confused. So
What do you mean by donated?
The city, from what we understand, the city owns those fields, and that they were donated to the city by the government. We were told that there were, when Fort Harrison closed, they donated, the government donated those fields to the city of Lawrence for the purpose of Lawrence Soccer Club. Now, we have been kind of trying to do some research on that to find out the validity or the whole history behind that. I do know there is a gentleman by the name of Larry Harmon, and I know the road by there is called Harmon Way, so it was named after him. He just recently passed away, so we cannot go to him to find out. But it's said that he had a huge hand in acquiring those 21 fields that we have, that a portion of is on our side. So we were trying to find out a little bit more history on that. Do any of you know the history as far as
those parcels were deeded to the city of Lawrence in the transfer in 95. There was a portion of those fields, specifically the North Fields, that was owned by a developer, was privately owned, and that was, we traded some properties, the city did. So the city owns all the property now within the confines of Community Park. There are certain restrictions on certain parcels because we use land water conservation funds, and because of the deed restrictions from the Department of Interior, that we can't donate even to a the only classification there. It's a zoo and some other, there's just
it's
a couple
very narrow.
Very narrow entities that, the city can donate property to on those parcels. So I don't know if that includes the areas where you're playing or not.
Okay. So in other words, that's why we license it, because we can't actually effectuate any kind of transfer of ownership in the form of a lease or a donation.
Okay. Most of our, and our youth leagues are unique in that standpoint. Like the Fall Creek Little League is an example of being, that facility sits on former Fort Harrison property.
Landfill, mm-hmm.
Lawrence Lions baseball falls into that category. Got land that we got in the 50s from the feds, and like I said, the soccer facility, it sits on property the city got from the feds. And, well, Gene, our football fields are same, fall into the same category.
Uniquely, the
the
back 7 acres still are owned by the federal government.
And so, in essence,
we have never acquired deed on it.
And my head had spun also when you try to jump through the hoops of what we can, can't do, develop on those properties, and like you said, either give away or donate. Okay, it keeps lawyers employed. Okay, and not to put you off, but we are such uniquely placed in the city of Lawrence of where so much of our youth sports properties have come from. Because we were so tied to the federal government when Fort Harrison was the active military base that it once was, as they gave parceled off lands, we were there. But in return, it's limited what we can and cannot do with those properties.
Okay. So what I'm hearing is that the land was donated, but it was donated to the city of Lawrence rather than the Lawrence Soccer Complex.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yep.
And then so the land that the veterans building is on right now, is that separate from the land that the soccer fields are on?
Yes.
Okay, so they weren't able, because that's where it's kind of confusing, because Indiana State Soccer was housed in that building.
Mm-hmm.
And from what history shows, they were housed there at the same time as that the land was donated or something, so that, Indiana State Soccer was involved.
They purchased that property where they built the building, mm-hmm. and then also the 2 acres that was south of that, that open area between the concession stand.
Yes, right.
They bought both those parcels that the Indiana State Soccer Association did.
Okay.
And then they sold it when they moved to Westfield.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And then so Larry Harmon's part in it, he just helped to get Lawrence, the city of Lawrence, to allow us those fields for soccer.
Yeah, Larry was very instrumental in development and bringing the regional tournaments in, and he sat on the national and the U.S. Soccer Association board, brought a lot of notoriety in soccer to the city of Lawrence, but didn't actually have anything to do with the physical property being.
Okay, that explains that. So thank you. That helps. So with that being said, so we'll move to Plan B.
That's fine, huh?
Rather than the fields be donated, we would like to have exclusive rights over the fields that are on the side that we have always operated on. So they are referred to as the North Fields. That is Field 15 to 21. We would like full access back to our concession stand we have always had until this new proposal came about.
To clarify, no proposal was ever sent out that said you could not have a concession stand. That was a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding on whose part?
On yours. It spelled out that you would need to request it from the Parks Board, but as you've seen with all these special use agreements, everyone who wants exclusive use of a concession stand, that's a special term we insert in there that the board has to approve.
I beg your pardon. In the management of community park soccer complex, it was spelled out in FC Pride's, what would be given to FC Pride, it says exclusive access to one concession stand.
That's for them. That's for FC Pride, correct?
Right.
And so for LSC, it would be LSC would have exclusive right to concession stand.
No, that's not what it said. I need to pull out that document.
But it would say that for them, correct?
Okay.
I'm asking questions.
Okay. Well, I guess what we could just say is, regardless of what it said, that's what we're asking.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Makes sense. That.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Dual ownership and access to the barn and the equipment there within.
What barn are they talking about?
The soccer. I call it the soccer maintenance barn. It's in the back by the maintenance compound. That pole barn that just sits to the east. By the railroad tracks.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Paperwork that we were given, it was equipment and pole barn that previously belonged to LSCI that is needed for upkeep and maintenance of the fields, except for those owned by the Parks Department or privately owned by Mark Lemon, and that was stated that would go to FC Pride. So we are asking for that to be reconsidered. And reason for that, distribution of LSCI assets. What we got out of that is that City of Lawrence would receive the pole barn and all goals. Lawrence Soccer would receive waiver of $21,570 outstanding balance owed to LSCI. We did ask where that amount came from. I don't believe that we get a response on where that amount came from. But we do have documents that were sent to us which shows LSCI income and expenses, and on this it shows that we have paid from 2006, and we are paid up to 2016, so therefore we have no outstanding balance owed to LSCI. Okay. That is what was given to us as far as distributing the LSCI assets. So being said that we no longer have an outstanding balance, we would like to have access to the rights of those equipment that the funds that we paid to LSCI went towards. And those the equipment in there is for upkeep of the fields, for our maintenance person to be able to seed the grass, seed the grounds, paint the fields, things like that, move goals to the barn during the off season. So that is our other request.
Ms. Morrow, excuse me just one second there. Because last time, when we got together last, did we have an exchange of those asset inventory
The document she's referencing is the proposal that came out of the soccer subcommittee
okay.
that delved into this
okay.
in detail.
Have we seen any of that before?
You haven't as a board. Jeff has and Carol has.
That's why I'm wondering. Is this premature that we're going through all this
issue is separate and apart from a license agreement going forward. So we need to keep those two topics separate.
Okay.
Because I'm confused.
Okay, can I ask this? I don't want to confuse anybody and be saying things that don't need to be presented. So Morris, since it was you that contacted our attorney and asked us to be here at this meeting, can you tell me exactly, is there anything that you want from us right now, or did you just want us to be present to hear what you were speaking about? I'm not sure.
No, I am writing down all of your requests, and we'll put it in documentation form, and then the board can vote on whether they accept those terms or not.
Okay.
But I needed to hear those.
Because I don't know. So all I got was, can you be at the Parks Department meeting? In the contract. So I'm just trying to see if I'm speaking out of turn, okay?
Well, and I understand that you spoke Monday night and may have had some grievances, so we wanted to give you an opportunity to discuss those with the Parks Board since they're the ones who make the decisions on these licenses.
Okay, so you want to discuss the grievances?
Mr. President.
Sure.
The, It was my understanding that the committee was going to work this out and bring it to us after we had, you had some kind of agreement, because it's pretty complicated
yes.
for us to do in this venue, I think.
And that's kind of, yes, that was, and the issues of grievances, that's the main thing I'm all ears on, because I was, especially on one of them, extremely taken back, knowing at least my temperament. But the items as far as hammering out a agreement, a license agreement, a contract, I think that's when I threw out, let's check our calendar so we can get together, soccer committee, when Carol gets back, and as much as possible before December 6th, where we can get a license agreement worked out between LSC and the city. Okay, that's why I said, please check your calendar. And I'm flexible. I'm at your mercy. So whenever you can fly that, I'm willing to go for it. Okay. And I think we'd all feel more comfortable doing it through the committee, and then we'll bring it back in December. Because I'll go ahead and say whatever we get done in committee, I'll feel comfortable with this board acting on it in my absence. Okay.
And may I address, is it Mr. Burns?
Yes.
Okay. I just wanted to address you personally. Because I remember the last time we came and had a meeting, and then we sat here while the committee discussed things. You seemed to care about Lawrence Soccer Club.
Yeah.
And I remember you stating, and correct me if I don't have it totally correct, but I remember when you were asking, when they were telling about what the different soccer clubs were going to have to pay, you asked specifically what FC Pride was having to be paid. And you also said, because our club comes first, something to that along those lines when you were speaking with LSC. Is that kind of similar?
Well, there's a lot of moving parts on this. And that's what I'm having a hard time with.
Okay.
So, I don't see anybody necessarily as coming first. I don't remember saying
that's
that.
That's what I wanted you to comment.
Yeah, I don't remember.
That's
not my recollection. But
okay.
Because I want to treat everybody fairly.
So I don't say that. You
right.
were concerned about
I'm concerned because you're doing a lot of good.
Okay.
And I want to make sure that that continues.
Okay.
But I also want to make sure that we get an agreement, a total agreement. And that's why we would have a very hard time working out this out here tonight.
And that's what brought us here today, because basically what happened was, along the lines of with further communication, it appeared as, I can tell you that nothing that we asked for did we get. Nothing. And so that's why it came to this point where the concern was, because basically to us, who is involved with the soccer all the time,
mm-hmm.
The suggested proposals that we saw so far would be pretty much Lawrence Soccer Club losing its identity. And that's where our concern came in, because that's one of the things that we were told was important, and that was not to go away. And the information that we received, we were afraid of that. So that's just to give you some idea of what brought us here. So with that being said, we will look forward to, are we going to have...
What were the dates that you wanted in 2017?
The dates that we're requesting for the soccer?
Yeah, for your season.
March 1st, 2017 through October 31st.
Thank you.
With the rights to request other dates, should those come about, the dates that, kind of like what she requested, are what we have in place at this time. But there are things that we have kind of been working on, like training, extra training and things like that, which we don't have in place now. So we're hoping that that's not going to be just locked in, that it will be open to request other dates as well.
It can always be approved for those dates, and then if you need to go into November or December or something, you can request an extension from the Parks Board.
Let me put out there then, parking lot redone.
You gotta get in line for that one. You gotta get behind us first.
We've talked about that many times.
We had that request from a lot of people. lot of the patrons.
Do you get
them?
I agree.
They're fighting the cold and the rain.
Yeah.
So should I continue on with this or leave this for the next meeting?
Well,
or send it to you. The
details of the 2017 one, if you want to go ahead and get those on the records, that way I can draft it and you can have it ready at the committee meeting.
Okay.
Go. Yeah, that'll work.
So that would be the full access to the concession stand.
Mm-hmm.
Control over our side of the field, on the field. Payments directly to the city. So we would like to make our payments directly to the city.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's what you did this year.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Make sure that stays in place. So no third party involved. And just from listening, from what you've been talking about, some of the other soccer organizations, it appears that $15 seems to be what everybody's paying per player. And so we would request the $15 per player as well. One of the things that we were, had said $20, in other words, charging $5 for players that were out of the Lawrence community, but I haven't heard that that's in place for anybody else. So I'd like to keep, we asked for fair as far as the payments. Okay, and that would be it for the 2017, I think, right?
Patty, just for my own clarification, do you have any idea how many players are City of Lawrence residents versus Lawrence Township or even outside of the City of Lawrence or outside of the township?
No, not off the top of my head, but if that's something that the board would like, I'm pretty sure I could do that. It would take some time probably because we don't have anything actually in place, but I think if I go through our website and look at, I can do that. Is that something?
I do that for a couple of reasons, for my own clarity and the clarity of our council president. He's asked that we look to ask Indianapolis for additional funds coming back to our park system. And if we're funding 75% of your players are outside the City of Lawrence, but we're funding them through our facilities, then we need some adjustment back from the City of Indianapolis. So yeah, any information would be appreciated.
So what you're saying, that's going to be required of all sports?
OYO does it. Just with a simple
zip code
search.
Zip code.
Fall Creek Baseball gave us
the
breakdown.
So we're looking at most of the leagues run about 60% Lawrence residents.
You'll be amazed. I'll go ahead and say it. I've asked for 10 years and I've been told by a previous administration to be quiet on it. It'll never happen. But forever, Jerry Riley, when he was board president, we have asked. Like I said, we subsidize Indianapolis $250,000, and we're providing their youth. We're now providing Fortville and McCordsville with OYO. I get my dander up on this one pretty solidly, that we subsidize Indianapolis due to Unigov. And like I said, I've been told to shut up before. It's a waste of time to do it. But I think if citizens of Lawrence realize that the subsidies we're providing the youth of Indianapolis, it's mind-boggling. And I know there's a great need, especially our location's unique, and I understand that. I teach those kids. Kids have not a lot of substance. But as a city of Lawrence, especially this department, a city of our size, we're grossly underfunded, and we're subsidizing a much larger city who doesn't pay a whole lot for their parks to begin with.
Yes,
and whatever
sure.
You can do, whatever. This has kind of been a crusade of mine.
Okay.
That gets my dander going, so if I start cussing here in a minute.
Should I send that to Mr. Martin?
Yes, please.
Yeah, any of us will. It all comes together.
How are we noting them by the zip code, you said?
So that's really about the only way you can do it.
Okay. Can you tell us the zip codes that are all in one so we can make sure that we have it correctly?
46216, 226.
236.
236 and 235.
Okay.
216.
216.
I got 16, 26, 35, and
36.
Yeah. That's all of them?
Yeah.
Okay.
19.
And 56.
56.
Okay.
No,
56
is.
Just
that's township.
That's
township.
Lawrence Township. Okay.
It is, yes. Some parts of Lawrence.
Yeah.
In the city.
Is it really?
Yeah. 56.
It is.
Okay.
Yes, it is.
Is that on the north side?
Yeah.
That's along Fall Creek, isn't it?
Yeah. It'd be called.
Yeah, it's over in Lawrence North.
Well, yeah, that's City of Lawrence, but we're just staying strictly in the City of Lawrence.
Yeah, Fall Creek.
Yeah, like where Collier lives. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think Collier's
some of the residents north of, south of Fall Creek.
There you go, yeah.
Have 5-6 as their zip code.
Yeah, because I think Collier's a 5-6.
They're still in the city.
Okay.
Double check.
Yeah.
Good double check. Make sure we have access zip code.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then we're going there. I don't want to exclude any zip codes.
Right.
And that could be one that can be crucial.
Yeah.
Okay, you never know.
Yeah.
All right. So let's just do a search.
Doesn't hurt. And I guess my last point is, I have to say this, I was really taken aback by just one comment about, and I felt very good that you addressed the council Monday night, but in the comment when the phrase retaliation came up, kind of, anybody knows me, I've taught Lawrence Township kids for 30 years. I've coached them 33 years. I lived, you know, when I come to a meeting, most meetings, I am probably the longest living resident of the City of Lawrence when I appear at any meeting, 54 years. I just, you know, was taken aback when I hear that phrase retaliation. And I guess what really bothered me is, especially when we met the one time, I have a phone, I have an email, and I mean, you folks know me well enough to pick it up, give me a call, email me, jeff@lawrencenorth.com. I live here, I'll drop anything if we need to have a conversation, if it appears somebody, if you feel like you're getting wronged or some injustice towards your program. That's the only thing that concerned me more than anything, because I'm sure as hell I'm not going to put you, because you guys, are, like I said, you're crazy for wanting to run a youth program, but if it wasn't for crazy people, we would have no youth programs in the City of Lawrence. And I grew up playing here, and I coach here, live here, so... So the thing that really bothered me is that I sure as heck am not out to put screws in anybody. Like I said, I got to live here. I have your kids, as they get older, in my classroom as ninth graders when they come along. And so, you know, understand that. Because I'm sure as heck not in the gotcha business because I don't like to have meetings to have meetings. Like I said, I coach and teach those kids. And I'm not out to get anybody.
Mr. Bess, I thank you for that. And I wish that that had been conveyed to us because we are, you know, we're just we're members of the community.
Right.
I always say, you know, please forgive my ignorance. Politics is not my forte. So we don't know what we are able to do, what we're not able to do. And when you're dealing with an attorney, but yet you don't have an attorney on your side, you again, don't know
drug out.
What
out.
To do. Okay? And I would like to come back with, it was told to us by our attorney that it was conveyed to her that our group is a mess. And while you say you don't like to hear retaliation, I don't like to hear that either. I would have loved to have had, if you felt it that way, I would have liked you to have come to us and let us know in what way are we a mess, what can we do to change your opinion of that. What we would never give an opportunity, you never came to us and said, you know, we're kind of getting this information because it wasn't coming from us. So we're kind of getting this information. This is kind of what's going on. And let us have a chance. So hearing that and then seeing how nothing that we asked for was given to us, what do you expect us to think?
Got it. Point.
And that's where that came from. So there's fear here. I stand before you. I'm shaking. You probably can't see that. I can't sleep at night. And all I'm trying to do is keep a club going that gives to our community and that takes care of our children. And I don't believe any of you have any idea what I'm talking about. Okay, I tell you, my daughter is disabled. She has epilepsy, asthma, anxiety disorder, all of those things. She was not accepted when I tried to get her in school, sports. She was denied because of these things. I found Lawrence Soccer Club because I worked across the street and I would look over there and see those kids running around. So I walked over there one day and I talked to them and they accepted my daughter. She remembers that. She's 16 years old now. She was 8 when she came to NYSL. She remembers that. I stand here fighting for this club. Like I said, I'm afraid, but my mother always taught me, you don't let your fear conquer you. And the other thing is my daughter reminds me every day, Mom, please don't give up. They're the only place that accepted me. I see my grandchildren, they're autistic. They play at Lawrence Soccer Club. We have deaf children. We have coaches with Parkinson's disease. It's all of those things. Lawrence Soccer Club is a family. We're not an organization. We're not a business. We would love to help the city of Lawrence and give you money. We can do that. But you have to talk to us, tell us, work with us. That's all we're asking. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Anything else for the good of the cause?
You still on public comment?
Yo!
We have one question.
Sorry.
I don't think it doesn't need it to sub questions.
Oh.
Joe Williams. And so my interest in this thing is based on what I was elected to do, and that is be physically responsible for the city's finances. I want to know, and I talked to the contractor as well, and we want to know where are the transaction receipts from the third party entity. Was it LSCI? We want to know where those transactions and what percentage of that goes to the city. Those numbers, my understanding, this agreement came into existence in 2004. So now we're in 2016, so we're talking 12 years of receipts or transactions. And if an entity or entities have been paying to a third party for the usage of city property, I think we may have a problem. Because it doesn't make sense. If any entity that utilizes city property, we have our Parks Department in place to receive the funds directly. And we should not be paying as a city any third party. I think we can manage that. Eric been doing it for decades now. And we just need to, my main concern is making sure that our city move forward with accurate books and accounts so we can track our finances for our city.
So I agree with you, and I think I can partially answer it.
Okay.
No funds ever came from LSCI back into the city coffers. It was created to independently operate the soccer fields at Community Park.
Okay.
When we came in on January 1st and started looking into the issue, we discovered that LSCI had been administratively dissolved by the Secretary of State.
Mm-hmm.
No one has been told to pay into LSCI in 2016. Okay. All funds are coming directly to the city.
So we're tracking from 2016. So
forward, yeah.
So from the standpoint of 15, 14, 13, you know, we just need to make sure that we're tracking so that we can protect our parks. And part of the other concern was when like Eric was saying, getting those zip codes so that we can go to Indianapolis and say, give us our fair share so we can protect our parks. I'm a firm believer in that, and do let me know, and I'll stand firm with you going down there and say, give us our fair share.
We're very Jerry Riley along. We're laughing. Don't we? Laughing. So we nailed that.
You know, some days, history.
You know,
I'll lose my mind.
We're fighting.
Yeah, I'll lose my mind.
All right, thanks, folks.
Thank you.
Folks, anything else?
Nope.
I entertain a motion to go home.
So moved.
Let's go home. It's unanimous.